this session, I'm going to go over some of the basic features of Microsoft Excel, such as adding formulas in a cell to calculate values, formatting part of the worksheet, and using various formulas such as sum, maximum, minimum, average, and count. So let's assume we have this data here in Excel. I simply type this. There's nothing magical about it. You just type those values. And then those values, the first thing that we are going to learn here is how to format these values here, these numbers, into currency. So all that you have to do is you select the cells that you want to format a certain way with a certain type of formatting, and then we can either click here under dollars or on the drop down a different currency, or we can click on the drop down here and choose currency. And notice the dollar amounts have been entered. Now, at this point, we are going to learn how to add a formula in this cell to get the totals for training for all the months. So one of the concepts that is important to understand is that all formulas in Excel start with the equal sign. So you have the equal sign, and then you have the function. The function could be sum, or it could be something else. And there are hundreds of functions in Excel. We'll get to those later. Then the third part of it is the range that you want to calculate, or what you want to calculate. Now the range, it's typically expressed by the cell address for it, or the reference to it, the cell reference to it. So for example, if I wanted to calculate these numbers from here to here, that would be E6. Through E14. So if I could put in here E6:E14. And notice it's highlighted in blue, and also it's displayed here in the formula bar. And then we hit enter here in a moment. So again, you have the equal sign, the function, whatever the function is, and then the range, and the area within the range is represented by a colon. And then you hit enter. And that is going to be calculated. So you can have those calculations anywhere in any cell as long as it contains a specific formula. So in this case here, the easiest would be for us to insert this formula. And I'll show you the first one by doing this manually. We do the equal sign, then this would be C6. So we need the function first, then C6:, that represents anything from here to here through E6, and then hit enter. So that's one way to do the calculation here. The other way to do the calculation is by using this under editing here. You have this drop down here for sum, average, count, numbers, max, minimum, and more functions as well. So let's say we want the sum here. So the sum, we clicked on sum here, and notice it selected this section automatically. If you're going to use this feature, however, make sure that it's calculating the right range of cells. If that is correct, you just hit enter, and now it did it for you automatically. Another method to enter the formula here is by hitting the equal sign, then the function, and then you can simply select the range that you want to calculate, or you could click on the actual cell references, and that way you then have to line them up manually. Then you hit enter, and there it is, the calculation. We could do the same thing down here as well. And by the way, I have these comments here as to how to calculate it, so if you're following this tutorial, you can also download the worksheet and follow it on your own. Now down here, we want to calculate all the expenses for January. So we click here on the equal sign, sum, like we learned earlier, open parentheses, select the whole range, hit enter, and it's done. Now, we need to calculate it for the other months as well. So is there a shorter way of doing it? And the answer to that is yes. You can use what's called the autofill feature. The autofill feature, instead of you having to go through each one of those cells, what you can do is you can copy and replicate that same formula. So this is our formula. We can replicate it to all the cells following downward, or all the cells going from left to right. So how do you do that? All you have to do is you just click on the cell reference here, and then hold the mouse on the bottom right here when it changes to a little plus sign. and then just drag it down. And notice it has performed the calculation. One thing to keep in mind here is that double check whether those references are correct. For example, here for 88, is it calculating the right stuff here? This also works from left to right. And notice this is our formula, and we can drag it to the right by when it changes on the bottom right to a little plus sign, drag it to the right, and it's going to give us the totals. Notice what it's doing. It's taking it from C6 through C14. Then you go to the next one, D6 through D14, E6 through E14, and so on. So it's going, it's seeing incrementally from one point to the other to the other. And this works the same way for anything in sequence. So for example, you have Monday. You drag this down, it fills the days of the week. Anything like January. And it proceeds the same way. The other thing that you could use this for is for numbers, for example. Now for numbers, you either have to hold down the control key to do it automatically, or you can click right here in the bottom and choose to fill the series. It's gonna just keep on moving them. And there it is. So control button or fill a series for numbers. You can also do things that are in a certain sequence of other sorts. For example, let's say you want to have anything in a certain sequence, for example, 5, 0, 5, 10, 15, and so on. So you select your pattern that you have, and then you drag it down. And notice it's building this automatically for you. So that's how you use the autofill feature. Now the next thing, another function here is the maximum. The maximum is determining, based on these values, we want to determine which one was the highest number in this column. So you can do this with a formula. In Excel, you can click on formulas here, and you can see all these different groups of formulas or functions, actually the functions. And then you can see here under all, these are all the different functions. Now what we could do here is we could just choose, we want to find the maximum. So if we start typing max here, or you could have typed maximum, notice it comes up with a bunch of suggestions. So notice here max, it returns the largest value in a series or in a set of values. So you have a set of them here, and it's going to give you the highest one. Now to learn how to do it, you can also click on help on this function, and it will go on the web, and it will give you examples, descriptions, examples, and all kinds of other information about any of those, how to do it, and so on. So keep that in mind, that that's how you learn about other formulas. We'll not be able to go through every single one of them. Now, here we want to insert to find the highest number. So we do the equal sign, max, you can double click on it, and then you select the range that you want to find the highest number. So you select the range here. We don't want the total, of course. Hit enter, and the highest number is 500. If I change this to that, notice these all these calculations will be updated automatically. Now, if I wanted to get the highest number for the other columns as well, I could use the autofill feature that we covered earlier. Just simply drag this to the right, and then we are all set. The next one is we want to find the lowest number. So we are finding the minimum. We do the equal sign, MIN, open parentheses, and then select the range for your calculation. Hit enter, and now there is the minimum. Use the autofill feature, and we are set. Then we want to find the average. The average, you could either do equal sign average, or don't forget as well, we have this stuff up here under the Home tab. Notice there is also this drop down here under to find the average. Now notice it's trying to pick the wrong sequence of numbers here. So we want to select here the right range and then hit enter. And that's why I like it to do this manually. Use the autofill, and there it is. Now you can also count how many values are in here in this range. So we can do equal sign, count, and then open parentheses, and then hit enter. So there are 9 rows in here. And then in this one, there are only 8. Notice one of them is blank. Okay, so far we learned how to add some of those totals, how to format these numbers into currency, and also we learned how to find the total, the sum for a bunch of numbers. We learned maximum, minimum, average, and count. Here is another example that you could explore for yourself. Tinker with those on your own as well.